Well, hello everyone. It's Tanya Gabrielle here, wealth astrologist. Today we're going to dive into the Taurus new moon on May 4th, happening at 11:45 p.m. in London, 6:45 p.m. New York Eastern, and 3:45 p.m. in LA, which is Pacific time. So it's happening May 5th. If you live anywhere east of Great Britain, that would be Europe, Asia, Russia, Australia, New Zealand, India, South Africa, all of those places, Africa, of course, are going to experience the new moon on May 5th. Now, even if you're not a Taurus, or if you don't have your rising sign in Taurus or your moon in Taurus, this forecast is still applicable to you because you have Taurus somewhere in your astrology chart, and it's in that area of your life that you're going to feel these new beginnings in this very powerful earth sign, the second sign of the zodiac. Now, I really love this new moon because it's so delicate and so sweet, and it's a really nice change from the two lunations we had in April, especially the second one, the Libra full moon. So the Libra full moon in April, at the end of April, was very, very dynamic and a little bit tense. And now we're getting into this sweet, caring, sensitive energy. It's very much about personal nourishment. It's not a particularly energized new moon. However, May is a 17 universal month, and that gives us all the energy we need. Now, Taurus governs the second house of money and values, but it also governs sensual pleasure and perseverance and patience and your self-worth. So those values that you integrate in yourself, right? That govern your belief systems. So Taurus gives you that sense of comfort, that physical comfort, to be able to explore and taste and sense and smell and see everything that's very sensual. And it gives you that solid persistence, that solid foundation to be in gratitude for those sensual pleasures and the simple things in your life. So Taurus is that sign that connects us to Mother Nature. And Mother Nature is the reflection of beauty. And it invites our five senses to explore and to be invigorated. And Taurus governs that part of our earthly experience, the Mother Nature part. So it's very important for you to get out, no matter where you live, whether it's autumn or spring, to really enjoy nature and get into the aromas and the whole beauty of our gorgeous Mother Earth. Now, May 4th is a four universal day. The universal time for the new moon is on May 4th. So even if you experience it on May 5th, the universal time is important. And four is very much connected to Earth. Four is the number of Earth. It's the square. It is a practical manifestation, putting things in order, having the four seasons, for example. That's an earthly experience we have. Having four directions, north, south, east, west. It governs our boundaries. It governs time. So this is a synchronistic event to have Taurus, the sign of Mother Nature, merged with the number four on May 4th. I love that. So the new moon itself happens at 14 degrees in Taurus, and 14 is the media number. That's what I call it. It's about communication. It's about setting you free to explore and express yourself. It's about change, adventure. So this new moon reactivates your connection, and that means connecting with any device that you like, including your phone or, you know, email, texting, whatever it is. But you're connecting in a very stable, peaceful, and practical way. So you're not wasting time, you're not getting distracted, but you're doing so in a way that is, the connection is meaningful. Now, Uranus moved into Taurus in March, and it'll be there for 7 years. This was a really big event. And Uranus is about freedom. 14 is about freedom, 14 degrees. So you're going to be purging the past in order to be set free. And that means unexpected breakthroughs can happen around this new moon, because both the number 14 and Uranus exemplify that shift that comes from being set free. So Uranus is connected, Uranus in Taurus is connected to the electrical system. So unpredictable energy, intuitive insights, and also revolution and volatility because the energy is so surprising. It's not stable. So if you resist change this month or around this time, it'll make you more uncomfortable because Uranus is really like shaking it a little bit, right? It's trying to liberate you, stabilize the energy at the same time because it's happening in Taurus, which is really lovely. And that also means it is liberating you from old, outdated beliefs about money because Taurus governs the house of money. So if you have financial flow issues come up, or you're dealing with how do I resolve this debt, or people owe you money, these are all things that you need to put your focus on and be clear and move forward with a lot of positive energy around this time. But also that means resolving those issues. You will really be helped though, because the sun and moon in this new moon are trying to Saturn, and Saturn is about discipline. Saturn is about creating those boundaries, right? And it activates that stellium, the conjunction of Pluto and Saturn and Capricorn. This is beautiful because this trine to Saturn activates Pluto as well. Pluto and Saturn are together. So long story short, the sun and moon are here. Pluto and Saturn are here in Capricorn. They're forming this trine, and it's happening May 4th. And that means it's going to give you patience. It's going to bring calmness. It's going to revolutionize things too, because Pluto is going to create a rebirth feeling, but it's in positive energy flow because of the trine. You have to the sun and moon sextile Neptune, which is in Pisces, its own sign. And sextile Neptune, this is really beautiful. It enhances romance. It enhances your imagination. It enhances your creativity. And you just feel super sensitive and loving and intuitive and sweet. You have empathy, and you're really open to sharing your heart with others with a lot of vulnerability. Right? When we're really loving and in that place of love, we become vulnerable, we trust. And this also enhances your psychic abilities, which is awesome. So you want to pay attention to those hunches or to your dreams. And they'll be extra vivid around this time. They'll be very revealing. So there'll be symbolic of things. And this sextile to Neptune also, like I said, it enhances romance. You can really go into that sweet, generous, loving place with your partner or with a potential partner. Mars is also opposite Jupiter during this new moon, which I love. This is great for abundance. It gives you the confidence and courage to just move forward. It makes you feel very magnetic. Your desire for success is fired up. You know, Jupiter expands. Jupiter is about wealth, wisdom, expansion. Mars is your energy, your drive, your ambition. When they come together, you really can move forward in a beautiful way. And business success is really favored as well, as is romance, because you feel so magnetic and your romantic desires can easily be fulfilled around this new moon. Now, Taurus's ruler Venus is at 17 degrees during this new moon. And this is important because May is a 17 universal month. And that means that any love that is started now, any romance around this time, will have this immortal feeling around it. Because 17 is the immortality number. And Venus governs not only money and values, but love. So this is a very exciting time if you're getting into a relationship. This is exciting because it will last, right? Venus is also in Aries at 17 degrees. So Aries is the first sign. So there's this sense of new beginnings as well. So there's a lot of intuitive energy in general with this new moon in Taurus. It is so beautiful, so sweet, so open, so loving, and balanced. Given that your intuition is on a high, that this new moon inspires you at deep soul level, it's a wonderful time to discover your own divine blueprint. Just go to blueprintclass.com. That's where you'll find out what your birthday means, what your birth name means, and how the stars and numbers merge together in your own blueprint. It's so exciting. You discover so many lovely nuggets about who you are at soul level and who others around you are at soul level as well. So go enjoy that at blueprintclass.com. And meanwhile, have a gorgeous Taurus new moon. I wish you a beautiful 2-week period here of just serenity and positive awakening and sweetness. And I will see you next in a couple of weeks for the very dynamic and very positive Scorpio full moon. Lots of love for now.